Good morning to all. Welcome to basic science class. Dear children, last day we discussed about reflection, regular reflection and a diffuse reflection. And then you can do that same experiment in your homes and you try it with the objects with a smooth surface and a rough surface. For example, mirror reflects light well, and aluminium plate, steel plate reflects light well. And you can do some experiment with the other objects with the rough surface, like a roofing tile. Then cloth, it cannot reflect light. Then all of you take your textbook and you can see some pictures in your book. First, one boy is reading a book. Look here, this is one torch. Then suppose this light is in our backside. What happening? This light reaches in the object, that is book, and from there it reflects in our eye. Then you can read with the with your eye. Then look here, this light is in the back side of this book. Can you read it? You cannot read it because it cannot reflect that light. And after that you can see some other pictures in your book. Second picture, zebra line. You can see zebra lines, and these zebra lines made by using a special type of paint, that is fluorescent paint. This fluorescent paint can reflect light. So in night time, suppose drivers can see this zebra crossing lines, and in some advertisement also they are using this fluorescent paint. In our road we can see this making lines with the fluorescent paint, because this fluorescent paint can reflect light. Then we can see the line, zebra line. This paint is another type of paint. You cannot see, drivers cannot see that light in night time. Then another picture, you can see one night time, one animal is there, but you cannot see it. Why you cannot see it? How can you see it? With the help of light you can see. If you are using a torch, you can see that animal. How? Because that light that reaches in the body of that animal, and that reflects back in our eye. Then we can see it. And suppose you are standing in dark room, can you see anything? No, you cannot see anything. But when there is light, you can see the object. How can you see the object? When the light falls on the object, that light reflects in your eye. Then you can see the objects. And one more picture is there. One boy is, two girls are looking in mirror. After that we can discuss it. Then, can you see your face? No, we cannot see our face. So look, I am standing here, but I can't see my face, but you can see my face. How is this happens? Because light reaches in my face. In my face light falls, but it cannot reflect in our eye, so I cannot see my face. But light falls in my face, reflects in your eye. Then you can see the object. Okay, then now we are going to see about mirror. Two girls are looking in mirror. We know that girls like to watch their face, look their face in the mirror. Then what they can see? They can see their image. I cannot see my face. How can I see my face? If I want to see my face, I want to use any object with the smooth surface. It may be a steel plate, but mirror is good with a smooth surface. Then that light falls in the mirror that reflects in my eye. Then I can see my face in the mirror. Okay, then next we are going to study about the laws of reflection. Here in the picture you can see a plane mirror. We can represent this plane mirror by using a single line, and you can shade one side of this line. That means it is a plane mirror. Then what is happening? When light falls on this plane mirror, that light reflects back. Then here these two rays that falls in the mirror and rays that reflect from the mirror, names are there. Then that ray that falls in the mirror is called a incident ray. Okay, then the ray that reflects back from the mirror to any other surface is called a reflected ray. You can see this incident ray and reflected ray in the same line. Then in the middle of these two rays you can see another line that drawn using dotted line. That means these are imaginary lines, and imaginary lines, so this imaginary line is called a normal ray. Then you can see two angles forms between this normal and incident ray. One angle is there, that angle is called a incidence angle. And one angle forms between the normal ray and a reflected ray. That angle is called a reflected angle. Then these two angles, incident ray, incident angle and a reflect angle, these two are same. Suppose the incident angle is 30 degree, the reflected angle also 30 degree. Suppose the incident angle is 45 degree, the reflect angle also 45 degree. That means the angle of reflected and the angle of incidence both are same. And we know that in a line you can take the measurement using a protractor. Then it's 180 degree, and these are these two angles also same. Okay, then thank you. Have a nice day.